Now the last part is creating a group. What is group? Basically, just like a team. Group is a similar type of people working in a same, working on same thing. So as you can see, जब भी कोई IT में आ रहा है, जब भी कोई IT टीम में आ रहा है, तो मुझे दूसरे का रेफरेंस लेना पड़ रहा है ना बार-बार. Whenever a new person is coming and joining IT team, I have to take a reference of that other person, right? मुझे याद थोड़ी रहने वाला है कि IT को कौन-कौन से को एक्सेस दिया था. So what I can do, I can put all the people who are working in IT in a single umbrella. So I can create a group, just like a WhatsApp group. Create a group, name it as a IT. And you can add user in IT group or you do. Okay. If you want, you can directly add the user. It's optional again. And even you can assign a permission. But right now I'm not adding any user or I'm not assigning any permission. I'm just creating a group. So a group is created. Okay, a group is created. So I have created an admin IT group. I have created an IT group. And in that group, in the user section, there is no user. User is zero. Permission, there is no permission. Okay, and I will show you this test. We created this user, right? Test. And in that test user, there is no policy, right? This is just change policy, the thing. Let's go delete it. So the test user has no permission here. So now I'm coming to group. I'm coming to IT group. And in permission, I haven't added any permission. So what can I can do? I can add and attach a policy here. So let's say मैं इसको देता हूँ बस S3 का देता हूँ बस S3 IT में ना चलो S3 full permission दे देते हैं इसको S3 full access. Now add. So now this group has a permission called S3 full access. अब मैं एक user को इसमें add करता हूँ. एक user को add किया test. And add. So you can see the user has been added to this group. So just like any group, when there is a group, when you create a committee, when you create an organization, a person who is in that group will have all the level of permission assigned to that group. If you see, if you check on the user now, now you can see there is a group policy. Now you can see a policy name attached from a group. There is no individual policy. Uske paas koi alag policy nahi hai. Sirf group policy right now. Where this policy came from? IT group. The user I will add will get the group permission as well. That user will be getting the group permission. That is right now S3 full access. Abhi let's add other. In our Harshil, add. And if you go to Harshil, if you go to the Harshil, you will see Harshil has two type of permission. Direct permission, which we have assigned previously. That is S3 read only, I am read only. And additional permission is given in a particular group. There is one manager and there are team. So in the team, you can assign a group permission, pura team. Even manager के पास को भी उस group में डाल दो. So from manager till and all the people in the group will have same level of permission. That is from group permission. क्यों? वो एक ही team है. Team permission और group permission. And because he is a manager, manager need an extra permissions which are not comes in a group. Okay, manager need some additional permission apart from group permission. So I can add direct permission just like we did previously. Direct permission. You can see direct permission. This is a group permission and this is direct permission. Just like in WhatsApp, you are sending message directly or you are doing message in group like that. You can create multiple groups here. You can create HR department. You can create IT department. You can create admin department. You can create accountant department and add people in that. So आपको बार बार permissions attach करने की जरूरत नहीं. Group में डाल दिया, जो भी permission group के अंदर है वो सारी permission उस user को मिल जाएगी. Now you can see my account number here in dashboard. Whenever we create a user, we are getting this URL, right? We are getting this account number. But as an organization, it is not recommended to pass the account number to people like in mail, such that. So what I can do, I can change this thing. Account number to change nahi kar sakta, to fix hai. But what I can do, I can put here some unique name, just like a username. Okay. So parag.jain, what is the month right now? September. So now we can see the URL here. Mera URL aisa dikhega. Pehle kaise dikha tha? Na pe account number aa raha tha, right? Now this will be the new sign in URL. You can see sign in URL. If I'm not putting anything, तो साइनिंग यूआरएल कैसा होगा? ऐसा दिखेगा, दिख रहा है यहाँ पे? If I'm not putting anything, तो मेरा अकाउंट नंबर आएगा. So I can put here some name, like generally here in organization they put an organization name. Take example Infosys. Infosys September 2021. मतलब ऐसे ही. So if this name is already taken now, then you will get an error. मैं example दो, Parag Jain, शायद किसी ने लिया हुआ. If you try to save this, alias not created for this account. Account Parag is already taken. Parag Jain is already taken. So this should be unique again. Okay, so Infosys भी ले लिया हुआ किसी ने. Infosys is already taken. Why? Because this URL should be unique, right? All the URL should be unique. Hopefully it's not taken by anyone. No. You can see not taken. Here is the URL. You can see now. This is my alias name. Alias मतलब nickname, duplicate name, duplicate मतलब दूसरा name. Alias is like AKA बोलते ना. Also known as my account number is also AKA. Also known as Parag Jain Sept 2021. So the URL is changed to this. Now if I create a user, let's create a user now. User. रैंडम का राम, ओके. और उसको सिर्फ प्रोग्रामेटिक एक्सेस देते हैं, ओनली प्रोग्रामेटिक एक्सेस. परमिशन EC2 फुल एक्सेस रीड ओनली एंड क्रिएट यूजर. आई एम डाउनलोडिंग नाउ. एज दिस राम डजंट हैव कंसोल एक्सेस, सो द पासवर्ड इज ब्लैंक. कीप इन माइंड आई टोल्ड यू, सो because Ram doesn't have console access, that's why password is blank. Ram can't log into from console. Ye interview, ye exam question hai bahut. User is not able to log in through console. What might be the reason? So because the user has been given a programmatic access, not console access. Wo ye user aur password se try kar raha hai login karne ka. So because the Ram user has only CLI access, not console access. Now you can check the URL. Here there is no account number. If I copy paste this in the browser, you can see account number or account alias. You can't remember digits, but you can remember this name, right? It's easier to remember the name rather than digits. That's right.